Hello friends, this is Durga from IT Varsity, a one-stop stop for all the technologies. As part of Red Hat Certified System Administrator playlist, in this video we will be talking about compressing and uncompressing files using gzip and bzip too. So far we have seen tar and star commands, and tar and star is to package multiple files into one file, whereas gzip is to compress an individual file into a smaller file. So for example, I am going to my VM, Red Hat VM, and if you see the data master directory which we have created earlier, and go to cards directory here, and then list the files, and then there is this small dex directory, and if you look at it, it has 100 files. We can do this command ls-ltr. WC stands for word count, and -l says that each line considered to be a word, and wc-l will give the line count. So there are 102 files in this, including I think I'm not sure why it has 102, probably some hidden files. And that is fine. There are 102 files, and if you look at the size of these files, the overall size is 1.1 GB. And when we try to copy after tarring it as part of the last video, it took almost 40 to 50 minutes, 40 to 50 seconds, 40 seconds for the tar ball or star ball, and 50 seconds for the individual means directory which have all the index individual files. So now we will see what happens when we actually zip these files. So there are multiple ways to zip, there are multiple algorithms, but as part of the certification they are asking about gzip and bzip2. So these are the two zip commands they are looking for, and to get the help for gzip you just need to say gzip-h. We will see the details about gzip first, and then we will also try with bzip2. Okay, so when you run gzip-h, it will show all the options. So there are several options. Mostly when we try to zip, we will not use many of these commands. We'll just run gzip and the command name, but you need to understand some of the arguments which are important while doing the compression. So minus f, so what happens is, first let us see how to compress a single file. So let's pick the deck of cards.txt. if you run gzip deck of cards.txt and hit enter, what will happen is the deck of cards.txt will be compressed, and a new file with the .gz extension will be created, and the old file will be deleted. Now if you see ls-ltr deck of cards.txt, you see only one file because the original file is gone. And if you see the size of it, it's only 55 KB because there is a lot of duplicates in the data. This 10 MB file is reduced to 55 KB, which means that it almost compressed by 99%. So the size of the file is less than 1% to the original size. And now if you try to copy these files, the copy will happen much, much faster than the uncompressed files. Okay, now there are several other advantages also. The amount of I/O that needs to be done to get the files into the memory will also reduce. But when you actually run the gzip command, or when you try to unzip it to process the data, it will take more CPU. So gzip compression is CPU oriented when it is actually trying to process the data. But you will get benefit at I/O level, and also if you want to copy the files from one server to another server, compression makes it much, much faster. And now let us see the other options on gzip by running gzip minus h command. Now it says minus s. What it will do is, if you see, the deck of cards is moved to deck of cards.txt.gz. So if there is another file, I am creating another file, deck of cards.01.txt to deck of cards.txt. Okay, and now if I run gzip, it will complain that file already exists because the deck of cards.txt.gz is already there. So it will prompt you whether you want to overwrite it or not. If you say no, it will not overwrite, and if you see, you will see both the files, deck of cards.txt as well as the gzip file. If you say gzip minus s deck of cards.txt, it will not prompt, and it will overwrite the file deck of cards.txt.gz with the new contents of the new file in the compressed format. Now if you look at the output, the date of the file will change. Because the size is same, you don't see much different, but the date of the deck of cards.txt is gone, and the timestamp of the file is same as the deck of cards.txt. Earlier it was 506, now it is 1311. Okay. So then gzip minus h, several other options. Minus l is to list the details of the file. So if you say gzip minus l deck of cards.txt.gz, you see that the compressed size is 55 kb and uncompressed format is 10 mb, and ratio, compression ratio is almost 99.5%, and this is the original file name. Okay, so that is about list. And then gzip minus d deck of cards.txt.gz, what it will do is it will uncompress the file. Okay, and also there is another way also to uncompress. You can run a command called gunzip, which will uncompress, but you can also do gzip minus d. So far we have covered minus d, minus f, minus h for help, minus l for list the files. You can also use this format to get so these two are aliases. So to list the details about a compressed file, either you can give minus l or minus minus list, both are same. So you can say minus l deck of cards.txt, because the file is not in gzip format, it throws error. And also you can say minus list also. Sorry, you have to give minus minus list. So if you use the full form, you have to give double minus or double hyphen. Okay, and then it will minus capital is not very important, it is for displaying the software license. And minus n is to no name, do not save or restore the original name and timestamp. So there is no clear distinction between minus n and minus capital N. I think that is not that relevant for the certification. Minus q, it will suppress all warnings. Minus r, if you have directory and if you want to compress recursively, then you use minus r. And minus t to test compressed file integrity, again that is not that important. Only important parameters are minus d to decompress, minus f to force. As we have seen earlier, it will directly compress the file even if there is a conflicting file name with a gz extension. And minus l to list the details, minus h we have been using for the help, and then minus r to do zipping recursively. For unzip, we have already seen a command called gzip minus d. You can also use gunzip and give the file name. And if the file name already exists, the same as the one which is compressed, it will prompt you. You can say y, or you can say n and ignore it. And if you want to just directly decompress with the underlying file name, you just need to use minus d minus f, which will do it forcefully. And now we will not see the a file with the GZ extension anymore, because it is encompassed and overwritten the existing deck of cards.txt. Okay, so this is how you can use gzip command to zip and uncompress. And then you have bzip2, another compression command, and you can do bzip2 minus minus help to see the syntax. The syntax is almost similar. So minus d is to decompress, minus z is for compression forcefully. If you just want to compress, you can just say bzip2 and give the file name deck of cards.txt in this case. And if you see, it took a little bit longer time because bzip actually compresses at higher rate compared to gzip. If you see here, it is only 5 kilobytes instead of 50 kilobytes when we actually do gzip for the compression. So bzip actually compresses at a higher rate, but it will take longer time to do that. Okay, and then bzip2 minus h, let's review the other parameters also. Even in gzip also, gzip minus h, if you look at the help, there are other parameters, minus l and minus 1 and minus 9. So minus 1 and minus 9 is minus 1 is for the fastest compression, so it might not compress as much it could be, but it will do it faster. Whereas minus 9, it is the best compressor, means it will try to get the best amount of compression, but it will be a little bit slower. So even in gzip you have these options, and even in bzip also you have this minus 1 to minus 9 at which rate you want to compress. So with minus 1 it will be fast compression, and minus 9 it will be best compression. It will compress the most if you do minus 9. And then you can do minus f to overwrite existing output files. Minus g force compression is a little bit different. So if you want to compress forcefully, in some cases you have to use this minus g. Minus k is to keep the input files. So if you look at the deck of cards, you can see that the deck of cards.txt is deleted after it is compressed into bz2. Okay, now I am actually saying bzip2 minus, what is the command to uncompress, minus d, or decompress is minus d. Okay, now it is uncompressed. Okay, now if you don't want to delete the file after compressing, you just need to say bzip2 minus k deck of cards.txt and hit enter. And now if you do ls minus ltr, you see both the files here. So it is not deleting the file after running the bzip2. Probably in gzip also there could be some command like that. Let us see. No, it is not showing up here. Okay, now going back to bzip help. So we have covered minus d to decompress, minus d for forceful compression, minus f to forcefully overwrite the existing output files, the same as gzip2 and gzip, and minus q quiet, it is not that important. Minus s, so it controls how much memory it should use at the time of creating the compressed file. And then, as I have explained to you earlier, minus 1 to minus 9 are different levels of compression which you can use. Okay, so go through these commands, and not everything is important, but practice as many as possible for the certification, and make sure at the time of certification also you can run this bzip2 minus h or gzip minus h command to get the help. Now we have seen two different commands for compressing the files, and now we will see how we can actually integrate with the tar or star command to compress the tarball while it is being created. Okay, so first let me delete this in the file. Okay, now if I want to create a tarball of the small def directory and also zip it, earlier we to create the file we have used minus c vf, c for create, v for verbose, and f for the file of the tar name. Okay, so if you want to zip, then what you have to do is you have to say c vzf. So I think you can put it in any order, z for zip, okay, and then give the name of the tar file. As we are compressing, make sure you give the extension .tar.gz. It's not mandatory, but by using this one, it will be readable for the users who will be using it down the line. So always better to give gz extension if you are trying to compress while creating the tarball, and then give the directory and hit enter. Now you can see that the files are being tarred or packaged. And if you look at ls-ltr, now the file size is only 5 MB instead of 1.1 GB. You can run also du-sh smalldex.tar.gz and hit enter. You can see it is only 5.4 MB. Similarly, if you want to run star command, so let's see the help, *-help, and you can see that there are commands or options to compress the files while doing the star also. If you use -z, it will be gzip. If you use -j or -bz, it is bzip2. So in the certification, they might ask a question saying create a tarball with bzip compression, then or starball with bzip compression, then you have to use -bz here. So *-bz-c-f smalldex.tar, and I want to do the smalldex. I want to create the tarball with bzip compression on smalldex. If you just use z, it will be gzip compression. So if you see, it is taking very long time because we are using bzip, and for each file it will take long time to compress compared to gzip. So it is taking very long time and I don't want to waste time here, so I have killed. But you can use this command. It has done some, it is still in the process. So I'm removing the smalldex.star, but yeah, you can do it the way I have done. Instead of bzip, let's try the zip itself, gzip itself, and also let's see the verbose, and now it is much much faster. So -d for gzip and -bz for bzip, or you can also use -j. Now it is done, and you can see the size of the file. It's almost same as the gzip with tar. And again, remember to have proper extension so that people understand that this is zipped file. So this is not correct. Means practically you can do it, but it's not a good practice to not to have the extension when you have when you compress a tarball or starball. In tar --help, so if you run this command, tar --help, you can see there are several compression options. We have seen z at the time of creating the file with cvzf, c for create, v for verbose, z for gzip, and f for file name. If you want to make it bzip2 compression, bzip2 compressed file, then you can also use -j. Okay, -j or --bzip2 also will work even with tar. So even tar supports both bzip2 and gzip. Now once the file is created like this, what you have to do is you have to use tar if it is compressed with tar, and X for extract, it's for unpacking the package, and Z for unzipping, and V for verbose, and F for file, and then you have to give the file name. Okay, let me create a directory, mkdir tar demo, mkdir tar demo. Okay, it is already there. Let me move smalldex.star to star demo, and then move smalldex.tar.gz to tar demo. Okay, because if I untar directly here, it will override the existing smalldex directory. That's why I'm just moving into some other directory. And now if you want to extract, minus X for unpacking the tar, Z for uncompressing the compressed tar, V for verbose, F for file, and then you can give the file name and hit enter. Now it will decompress the tar and then unpack the tar. And now if you run ls-ltr, you can see the directory, and it will have all the files which are originally part of the package. Similarly, you can go to star demo also, and then here you have to say star minus X for unpack, minus Z for uncompress, minus V for verbose, minus F for file name, and then smalldex.star, and hit enter. And then it will decompress all the files. You can run ls-ltr. And now, because the file is only 5 MB, after packaging into tarball and compressing, you can easily copy this one within few seconds compared to 40 or 50 seconds where we have copied individual files or the original the tarball which contains the original files. So this is how you need to mix and match the tar with the compression commands, so that you can actually package your files, compress them to move around. And especially when you develop a full-blown applications with multiple directories and multiple levels of directories and many files, packaging with tar and zipping it will make it make the distribution much, much smoother compared to using the entire directory structure for the application. That being said, I hope you are enjoying the content on the channel. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. If you have any technical questions, open in Stack Overflow with the appropriate tags. And if you want to discuss further about certification, please join my LinkedIn group, ITVarsity-certifications. We can discuss about any certifications. And finally, if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will get to see a lot more content over time. Thank you. Bye.